The world's toughest prison. Lock in here, chat.
Is there a fate worse than death? Is there a scenario where a criminal would gladly choose capital punishment over life imprisonment? Well, as surreal as it sounds, there are prisons in this world that make the death penalty a merciful sentence. Prisons riddled with unspeakable horror that would make your stomach turn. And in this video, I'm going to show you 10 of the worst. So take a deep breath, because things are about to get very ugly. Number 10, Black Dolphin Prison, Russia. Ask any Russian you know, and they'll tell you that life in any Russian prison is incredibly tough.
Gotta walk like that, bro? That's just humiliating.
But this high-security Black Dolphin prison redefines that quality. Located on the Kazakhstan border, Black Dolphin is one of Russia's oldest prisons, and it got its name from the statue at the front of the building, which the prisoners built themselves. That's strange, because Black Dolphin is not really known for its freedom. In fact, the only way to escape this prison is by dying. That is the fate of every inmate, because only inmates with life sentences are sent to Black Dolphin. The prison houses about 700 inmates, who together have a murder-
nuts! Oh, every person there is there for the rest of their life. For the rest of their fucking life, dude.
But murder is not the worst skill on their resume. Black Dolphin also houses cannibals, assault perpetrators of the worst kind, maniacs,
terrorists,
and pedophiles. Two inmates are forced to share brutally built 50 square foot cells that are secured behind three sets of steel doors. And these cells are under 24-hour surveillance, and guards make their rounds every 15 minutes. The prisoners hardly ever leave their cells.
Bent over at the waist and blindfolded so they can't.
But when they do, they're blindfolded and made to walk bent at the waist. This way, they never have a sense of their surroundings. There is no prison yard and no cafeteria, as inmates are forced to eat only meals of soup and bread in their dingy cells. If hell
every
was
every day for the rest of their life, they get soup and bread.
The prison, then Black Dolphin would be a strong contender. Alde Ciudad Barrios, El Salvador. Now, what could be worse than hell? I'm glad you asked. Allow me to introduce you to Alde Ciudad, the most dangerous prison in all of El Salvador. The reason it is so-
I still think I would rather be in one of those prisons than one that's overcrowded. The overcrowded prisons, like, they're gonna get into lists of those, like, that they're supposed to house, like, fucking 500 people and it houses like 6,000 and they're sleeping like shoulder to shoulder. That seems, even if they're not there for the rest of their life, I'm saying like that prison seems awful.
Notorious gangs, the MS-13 and the Barrio 18 gang. Death often comes without warning if an inmate is not a gang member. And that's why from 2004 to 2015, only gang members were sent to this hellhole. But sometimes, being a gang member is not enough. And most of the time, they are the least of your concern because the living conditions are so bad.
Like, that looks fucking awful, dude. They're almost sitting on top of each other. Imagine being claustrophobic. Oh, imagine being claustrophobic, sent to this prison, you would just start having panic attacks.
That getting simple things like food to eat or a place to lay your head could easily turn into a fight to the death with anyone contesting your claim. The prison's reputation for lawlessness and violence is so real that prison guards are terrified of entering the prison. And the result? The entire prison system is run by the gang members. Number 8. Petak Island Prison, Russia. It is called the Alcatraz of Russia for a reason. And that reason would put the fear-
I think most of the bad prisons, I don't really- there might be one US prison here. I think all the bad prisons are going to be Russia and South America. Where the South America because it's overcrowded, Russia because it's just fucking- cold, deserted, and you're there forever. Why so many Russian prisons? Probably because you're in the middle of fucking nowhere.
Sitting in isolation on the vast Nozovero Lake, this tiny island prison houses 193 prisoners, all on life sentences. Unsurprisingly, the inmates are usually the worst of the worst.
They're looking for anything that could be used as a weapon or a means of escape.
And each
of
them-
Bro, they really think they're gonna fucking get out? Like, there's no way you get out of this room. There are double metal grates on the fucking windows. You sleep on a metal bed, the walls look like they're fucking thick.
And each of them are kept in a small two-man cell for 23 hours every day. Escape is impossible because inmates are not even allowed out of their cell for any reason, and the 1 hour they are allowed out of lockdown is spent standing in a cage that they can barely pace in. However, the cherry on this terrible reality, what makes this prison worse than Black Dolphin, is the lack of basic sanitation facilities. There are no proper toilets and no proper bathroom.
Ooh, no lid, they just got the shit in a fucking... Oh, that's like shitting in a bucket. And that looks like poop on the ground.
Inmates do their business in a steel bucket, and they find sleep on thin beds. Some have likened...
Oh, wait, it's even worse. That was just a fucking reference photo. Do they shit in a bucket?
Living conditions of Pedak Island prison to that of a zoo in winter. And that is because the island is surrounded by freezing waters that contribute to the breaking the spirit of their inmates. Number 7, Bangkwang Prison, Bangkok, Thailand. Bangkwang Prison is one of the worst prisons.
Oh, I forgot about. Yeah, dude, like maybe some like pack. Dude, it's just like the overcrowded prisons are going to be the worst. South America, Thailand, Philippines, there's probably going to be some packed ass prisons.
And because the prison facility is so overcrowded,
it's trebled because of a government crackdown on drug trafficking.
These offending tourists have to cramp up in the same space with prisoners on death row, and the offenses that could boot you into Bangkwang are often very trivial. Reading the wrong book, staying in groups of five, or even eating-
Reading the wrong book! And I'm sleeping next to a murderer?
Staying in groups of five, or even eating a sandwich in public could-
Eating a sandwich in public is a crime?
Life in Bangkwang is beyond harsh for inmates. In the first 3 months of their sentence, new inmates are required to wear iron chains. To make matters worse, the food they're served is often infested with maggots, and drinking water is an absolute luxury. But it doesn't end there. Don't think you can just avoid Bangkwang by being a good citizen or tourist. A couple of years ago, a British man was thrown into jail when a Thai gang jumped him, and even though he lost an eye and suffered injuries, he still had to do time in Bangkwang for fighting back. 6.
He got jumped and defended himself and got thrown in prison. And he's a fucking tourist, bro. I would be so pissed. I would be so fucking pissed. And then he's stuck there. Like, I feel like, no, yeah, being in prison is ass. Being in prison in a country you're not even a citizen in, oh, that's fucking terrifying. Oh my God, if only I had a G Fuel shaker cup to perhaps have liquids in. Oh my God. Tagged below, bottom left, G Fuel shaker cup. Back to the video.
Gitarama Central Prison, Rwanda. Overcrowding.
Oh, dude, why did I say South American prisons and Russian prisons? I'm forgetting about, like, literally Asian prisons, African prisons. Because it's any prison where it's going to be overcrowded is going to be awful.
Is a common denominator with most prisons on this list, but there is no prison that has it as bad as Gitarama Central Prison in Rwanda.
God is intolerable. Today, it's holding 8,000.
In a facility originally designed to hold just over 1,300 inmates, 8,000 prisoners have been forced to share the space. In most
cases, those are kids. These are prisoners?
Cases, finding a spot to lie down on the ground is a luxury, and many inmates are forced to stand up all day or negotiate with those who have claimed portions of the ground. And it's not like the ground in dispute is some piece of fine real estate. It is damp, and more often than not, filled with raw feces. Unsurprisingly, this has led to more, what's the word again? Let's say, complex issues. Many prisoners have outright died from disease and suffocation, and if you were to mistakenly injure your foot, gangrene would set in, and you would either have to cut it yourself, risk death, or watch it fall from your body. But it gets worse than that. There have been several cases of inmates feasting on each other out of hunger, and the cannibalism could-
Oh my God, dude, how do they allow that? Eating each other? You can't even get fucking medical help? You got gangrene on your foot? You just gotta watch that shit fall off or die?
Even be worse than I just stated, because there is little to no documentation on the activities that happen behind these prison bars. And prison guards have been brainwashed to believe that the prisoners in their charge are subhuman. Last year, 2,000 people died in Rwandan prisons. An overwhelming majority of those deaths happened within the walls of Gitarama Central Prison. Number 5, Kamiti Maximum Security Prison, Kenya. What makes this prison immediately stand out from the rest is that it is home to the worst of the worst. Built in 1954 by its British colonizers, the prison was modeled after an old-style colonial system to house offenders during a state of emergency declared in October 1952. Today, it still has its original gallows, and it has gotten even more hellish than it was more than half a century ago. On one hand, it is overcrowded. A prison that should house 1,200 inmates has almost 3,000 inmates crammed within it. On the other hand, this overpopulation has bred serious viral diseases like HIV and AIDS, syphilis, tuberculosis, and a whole plethora of diseases that ordinarily should be under control. Even worse is the unending unrest and corruption that plagues the prison system. Since the prison is the government's favorite dumping ground for political dissidents, much of the population population is uneducated. This, in turn, has led to a telephone fraud ring within the prison system, where scores of prisoners defraud innocent Kenyan citizens of their money outside the prison walls. Kamiti Maximum Security Prison is a cesspool of chaos, and only the smartest, the bravest, and the most ruthless can survive behind its walls. Number 4, Gildani Prison, Georgia.
What's gonna be the worst? What country do you think the worst prison's gonna be in? It's probably going to be overcrowded and cruel. China? I don't know if they're going to have footage from one. I mean, maybe, yeah, like North Korea. Like a North Korean prison, some shit like that. But, like, that's like, they're not going to have footage of that.
Say the prison is better. They say the violence has stopped, but that doesn't take away the terrifying legacy of Gildani Prison. In 2012, a video was leaked by a 35-year-old former prison guard turned whistleblower who filmed the horrors that inmates pass through at the hands of other guards. The video is too graphic to show here, but I can tell you what they did and had been doing for decades to prisoners. Every night, random inmates were routinely sodomized with broom handles, and one of such was—
What is sodomized? Sodomy is having anal intercourse with someone unconsensually.
Featured in the videos, they were often beaten, drowned, their bones purposefully broken, burnt, all at the hands of the sadistic guards. It was
fuck. And then, like, the guys that are in prison are not even— the guards are worse than the people in prison. That makes no fucking sense.
Institutionalized torture in the 21st century. A former inmate would recall, "They tore off my fingernails, damaged my skull, broke my leg bones, ribs, nose, and teeth. I am 43 years old, but I look like an old man. I often fall down while I am walking." Today, they say the prisons are fine and that the torture has been brought to a halt, but I doubt you would want to check that for yourself.
Yeah.
Number 3, Mendoza Prison, Argentina. The top 90 most dangerous convicts in all of Argentina are held in Pavilion 5 of Mendoza Prison. That section is so dangerous that no guard has the balls to enter that section, and they often leave the inmates' meals at predetermined spots around the door. That might sound deviously cool to some, but don't be fooled. Unsurprisingly, the prison has a serious overcrowding problem. 1,600 inmates share a facility that was designed for only 600. There are no beds, and prisoners are forced to sleep on the floor, where they are often subjected to random, intense, and frequent torture. But it doesn't end there. Toilets are non-existent, as prisoners are forced to defecate in plastic bags and urinate in bottles. There is a literal sewer of garbage, human waste, and slime running through the corridors. And conditions have become so unbearable that there are reports that prisoners literally sewed their mouths shut in protest, demanding better living conditions. And yet, it still gets worse. Their food is sludge, and those who aren't strong, fast, or smart enough often go hungry and die under what the authorities have made a habit of calling mysterious circumstances.
That is nuts that they just let this shit happen.
Diyarbakir Prison, Turkey. Diyarbakir Prison was at the center of one of the most abusive regimes in Turkey in the 1980s and 90s. Thousands of Kurdish men and women suffered horrific forms of torture, and at that time, it was regarded as the worst prison in the world. These days, second worst, but nothing has improved. In fact, you could argue that conditions have gotten worse, because in the same prison where the sludges of society are being housed, children are also locked up within. But that these inmates are subjected to ranges from physical torture to psychological assault. On the more physical, violent side of things, inmates are beaten, violated, maimed, forced to eat excrement and electrocuted by their genitalia.
Forced to eat excrement and they're electrocuted by their nuts.
On the more psychological, dehumanizing side of things, the same inmates are forced to salute the prison director's dog, participate in random mock executions that might or might not ever happen, and forced to bathe in the sewers. To show you just how desperate the situation is, prisoners routinely go on dry fast, protesting prison conditions. And more often than not, these prisoners simply die from starvation. More recently, 4 prisoners set their bodies on fire, and later on, an inmate set his cell on fire before hanging himself in resistance. Number 1,
wow.
Camp 22, North Korea.
Okay, it is North Korea. How are they going to get footage of this, though?
Camp 22 is not just one prison facility. It is a series of identity—
And they send families there, don't they?
Prison camps containing up to 200,000 prisoners and stretched across the length of North Korea. The few extremely lucky survivors have likened conditions in the camp to the atrocities committed against the Jews during the Holocaust.
Wow.
Starvation is not a novelty. It is every prisoner's reality. Inmates are fed a sludge of cornmeal and cabbage every day for the duration of their existence. And to avoid dying of malnutrition, prisoners have to supplement their diet with rats and insects. Rats became such an essential part of their diet that rodents literally went extinct. If you know anything about the way rats reproduce, you'll know that that is impressive, to say the least. On average, 20 to 25% of the prison population die every year when inmates aren't dying of malnutrition.
25%, a fourth of the people there die every year.
The prison guards make their lives into a satirical piece of horror. Everyone is fair game to the prison guards. Little girls born in the camp are often fed to dogs to train them to be more vicious. Inmates are brutalized as stress relief for the guards, and if they attempt to escape, everyone in their family, even those unaware of their escape attempt, will be tortured. Pregnancy is also strictly forbidden. Those caught pregnant are often tied to a tree, the fetus cut from their stomach, and then they are shot, dying in Camp 22.
What the fuck? Bro, that's literally fucking like some Holocaust shit. That's going on now? They feed children to animals. Bro, there's no way. Jesus. Okay, now we're on to a horror video. Bro, that was a good-ass video. Jesus.